Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today is a very special day because it is, let me see if I can give you a guess. Ooh, balloons everywhere. Happy birthday, princess. It's my birthday! My mom embarrassed me at work today and dropped those off at my office. So thanks, Mom! Everyone needed to know I still love princesses. Yay! Actually, I don't even think that's an official princess. That's Barbie. But she looks like a princess. Anyway, today's video is just going to be a haul. I've been shopping. As I do. You guys know I love me a good shopping spree. So that's what today's video will be, a fun little haul. So if you guys are interested in sticking around to see what I recently purchased, then just stay tuned and keep on watching. Tonight is my birthday. Tonight is my birthday. Tonight is my birthday when I party like that. Is this bag from Zara. I found two pairs of super comfortable jeans that I had to pick up because I am just in a jean drought. Like, I don't have any really good, comfortable fitting jeans that I can wear throughout the winter. So I decided to take a little splurge and get two pairs that I needed. I believe this is the medium wash. There was a lighter wash than this and then a super dark wash. I have a very dark pair of jeans already, skinny jeans. And so I decided to go with this medium one. It's just a classic jean. This is definitely like a, I guess I call it like a skinny jean. It's definitely not a boot cut. But this is Body Curve Culture. They're super stretchy and comfortable. They have like a little bit of the distressed look. So they have some holes and rips already in it. They're kind of like that, distressed wash or distressed denim feel. They already kind of have that faded look in the middle. I just love them. They're so comfortable. So I got that pair, and then the other pair I fell in love with, and I don't really wear too many black jeans, but I just fell in love with these. They're kind of that like grunge look. They have this very unfinished like top. You can kind of see it's like the frayed top, and they sit super low on the hips, super stretchy, super super comfortable. They fit lengthwise pretty nicely. Again, it's a kind of like, it's definitely not a boot cut, so I'm guessing I'm gonna call these skinnies. And they have, again, like the unfinished edges at the bottom. They just looked awesome on, so I was like, I'm buying two pairs. Wanted to shout that out, but let you know that the sizes do run a little small, so that is that. Then the next store I went into was Lush. My girlfriend wanted to go in there and was looking for something specific. And of course, I'm browsing around and I have to leave with something. So I got two things from Lush. The first one is this, I think they call this a massage bar. It smells so amazing. I wish I had the name. If I can find it, I'll leave it in the description box below. But that's what it looks like. And I just realized my nails are not polished. Gross. So that's what it looks like. And it's actually kind of melting. I need to get that. I didn't have the AC on all day. This is one of their, it says Pearl Massage Bars. I'll find it and I'll leave it below for you guys. But anyway, that smelled amazing, so I wanted to get one of those. And she's like, do not leave this in your car because it will melt. And I can just tell from not having my AC on in my apartment that it's already starting to. And then you guys know I love these. These are just the bath bombs that you throw in a nice warm tub. And they smell delicious. There's all sorts of scents. This one is the Butterball scent. Again, I'll leave the description for it below. I think this is like $4.95. They have other ones too, like the honeybee one is like a really nice one. And that one smells really good too. So anyway, two things from Lush. The next stop I went into was Victoria's Secret. And I got, what the heck is that? I got two things. One, I recently took with me to vacation. So it was actually in my bin. I just put it away last night. This is the Victoria's Secret Coconut Beach Wave Spray. This is really similar to like a sea salt spray. I really like it. I pretty much use this in my hair for like those effortless beach waves. And like whenever I got back from the beach and my hair was like naturally dried from the water, I just threw a little bit of this in, scrunched it, and I just let it dry, and I kind of rocked those beach waves all day. So I was loving that. And then this I haven't tried yet, but this is a leave-in conditioner by Victoria's Secret. I'm running low on my leave-in, so I figured I would try this. It says it's got vitamin E and silk amino acids to deep condition, and also provides thermal protection, shields hair against heat and styling damage. So this one smelled really good too. If you've ever used their shampoo and conditioner at Victoria's Secret, there's like a very specific scent, and that's what this smells like. So again, two hair products. These were 2 for $20. I think normally they were $16 each, and I got 2 for $20 because they were probably getting rid of them for end of the season. So yep, just those two. I have the They're Real mascara. I'll probably be doing a review on this shortly. If you guys watched my Butter London Wink mascara, you knew I was super unhappy with that one. So I decided to go back and exchange that, and Ulta was really awesome. They didn't give me any trouble, and I was able to get this They're Real, and this is in the navy blue, Beyond Blue. So I got that. And also in a recent haul, you saw that I was loving the Kat Von D liquid lipsticks. I had one in one color, and I said that they were out of the shade Mother, and I was really upset. So, of course, I went back, and I finally got the shade Mother. So this is what it looks like, and it was actually sold out at my Sephora, and I was like, okay, that's it, I'm ordering online. So I literally went in and ordered it online, like at the Sephora, and they swiped my credit card, and they're like, okay, it'll be to you in like 24 hours, and it was super quick. So this is a really gorgeous, I feel like, transition shade for fall. It's kind of that Kylie Jenner-ish color, so that's what it looks like, and it dries a little bit darker, but you can see it's a really pretty dusty mauve. So that came super quick. I was really impressed, and I got that again at Sephora. I think that was $21. So I'll finish up with some stock goodies that I got today from Sephora and from Ulta. I believe I got less from Sephora, so we'll start. And the first thing is, I've been seeing like these masks are all the rave, so I wanted to check out this Tony Moly Rice Face Mask Sheet. This is the formula for clear skin. It says the rice face mask sheet transforms dull skin to look clear and radiant. So I wanted to try this. This one was one of the least expensive ones. I think a lot of them were like $8 and $9. This one was $7.50. And I will try that tonight and let you guys know how it is. Next thing I got is, I've used some of Sephora's masks before, like the ones kind of similar to this where you like lay them over, they're like a sheet mask and you lay them over your face for like 15 to 20 minutes. But then they have these little new ones in the travel section called sleeping masks, and you leave these on overnight. So they have a bunch of different colors, which obviously they're all different purposes. And I got the rose sleeping mask, and it says it's a mask enriched with natural rose extract to plump skin with water for intense moisturizing and gives an immediate radiant boost for hydrated, luminous, and brighter skin. So I wanted to give this a try because my skin was a little sunburned over vacation, and I figured I would throw some hydration back into it. And it says that this is inspired by Asian beauty rituals. Sephora has created these sleeping masks with specific formulas offering solutions for every skin's unique needs. And in the evening, you apply a fine layer over clean, dry skin, the face and neck, but also around the eyes. Let it work overnight. If necessary, rinse off any excess in the morning. So I thought that these looked pretty cool, and I was going to get a couple, and I was like, Rachel, slow your roll. Like, get one, see how if you like it, and then you can get more. So, oh, by the way, my mother has pretty much dried to its color. So it kind of takes like a minute or two for it to dry to its natural finish, and that's what it looks like. So gorgeous color. I highly recommend it. The other one that I have is in the shade... This was the other one I was kind of raving about. It's definitely lighter. This is in the shade Lovesick, and I'm just going to give you a quick swatch so you can compare how one is definitely lighter than the other. So this is the shade Lovesick, and this is the shade Mother. So Mother is definitely deeper, more mauvier, and the other one I would say is more on the pinkish lavender side. But both really beautiful shades to transition into fall, which I'm very excited about. Okay, so anyway, the sleeping mask, the rice sheet mask, those two. And I also am excited to try this. This is the Glam Glow. Everyone's familiar with like Glam Glow masks. So this is the Super Cleanse Daily Clearing Cleanser. It's a mud to foam formula. And I was like, okay, that looks kind of gimmicky. And so I asked the woman at Sephora. I typically find that they're pretty honest in their recommendations. They'll say, oh, that's good, but this works better. But she cannot say enough good things about this. She said they sell the full size. She didn't even know that they came out with the smaller ones, but she highly recommended that. So, and then two little freebies. So I went in there for my NARS Beauty Insider birthday reward. So if you are a Beauty Insider member, you get a NARS two lip pencils or like lip crayons. One is a red color and then the other one is a pink shade. So that's what that looks like. So I got one of those, really nice. And then I also had some rewards to cash in on. So I got this. I thought it looked pretty cool. This is the Urban Decay 7 Days of Shadow. It's a deluxe sampler. And basically, like, there's 7 different samples of their new collection. I think this just slides out. So anyway, there's like 7 different little eyeshadows in there. So I got that. So that was everything from Sephora. Just a couple of things from Ulta. You guys know I live and die by this. This is the Batiste Dry Shampoo, and this is in my favorite scent, Sassy and Daring Wild. All my friends that use this are like, holy smokes, it smells amazing, and it's hands down the best dry shampoo on the market. Like, I've used more expensive ones, I've used less expensive ones. This one is $7.99, so it's the perfect price point, and I love it. It definitely removes any traces of grease or any kind of buildup or anything from the roots. I love this stuff, so I got another one of those for backup. Oh, and by the way, my Lovesick just dried, so that's what that finish looks like. So you can definitely tell that they're similar, but Mother's definitely a little deeper. Then I got a nail polish, and I was supposed to do my nails before getting on camera, but I forgot. So my sister was wearing this color at my birthday lunch today, and it was this gorgeous, like, sort of mauve-y slash brownie color. So this I thought was pretty similar to like the color that she had on her nails. This is the Sally Hansen Insta Dry in the shade 170 Espresso. So I thought that that was a nice fall color, so I'm going to do my nails with that tonight. And then if you guys watch Nicole Guerrero on YouTube, she always, I feel like, raves about this stuff. This is the Sally Hansen Gel Shine 3D Top Coat. It was a little expensive. I thought, like, I think it was like 10 or 12 bucks. I thought that was a little pricey for a top coat. Like, this nail polish was less expensive than the top coat. But anyway, she raves about it, and if it extends my nail polish, then it's worth it. So I got one of those, and then just some hair dye. I need to touch up my roots tonight, so I will be doing that right after this video. And I probably just need to go to the salon, period, because I haven't done my hair in so long. Like, I'm naturally a beige blonde, but it's just getting a little too oxidized, I think, from the sun. So anyway, I'm gonna touch up my roots tonight. So just a Garnier Nourishing Color Cream. This is in the Extra Light Natural Blonde 100 shade. I like Garnier. I feel like my hair is always silky after I use it. And then, of course, more birthday rewards. Gotta cash in on them. So I got the Urban Decay. It says a little birthday perversion, and it is, if you guys have never used the Urban Decay Perversion Mascara, it's like one of the best on the market. It's a little pricey, but again, it's works wonders. So I don't mind paying a little more for something that works really well. So anyway, that is it. That is all I have for you guys today. I'll have some really fun videos coming up. So thanks for sticking around to watch my shopping haul, and I'll see you guys all in the next video.